An electric immersion rod water heater is a simple yet effective gadget that heats water in a matter of minutes. These immersion water heaters are most typically seen in households, businesses, and hospitals. In 1924, Dr. Theodore Stiebel developed the first immersion heater. In this video, let's break down how this heater is built and how it works. Construction of the immersion rod water heater. The main part of an immersion heater is its heating element, which is typically made of nichrome wire, which is an alloy made by mixing 1.5% manganese, 75% nickel, 20% chromium, and a small percentage of iron, which is coiled to maximize its surface area. And this coiled wire is passed into the protective tube or rod to get encased properly to avoid the electric shock. This protective tube is usually made of stainless steel or copper and is designed to be immersed in the water you want to heat. And in between the nichrome coil and the stainless steel tube, the magnesium oxide powder is filled tightly to make the heater shockproof. At the top, both ends of the heating nichrome coil are connected to the phase and neutral connections, respectively, and an earth or ground connection is also made from the outer protective stainless steel tube to discharge the excess current. The hook is fixed tightly along with the instruction label plate, which shows the immersion level of the heating rod in the water. The hook makes it easy to lower the heater into the water, and the connection setup is compactly enclosed with thermosetting plastic, which is a good resistor of heat and electricity. A 2 to 3 meter wire is fitted to take up a 3-pin current connection to the plug board using a 3-pin electrical cord. Working of the immersion water heater. When the heater is plugged into an active power outlet, electricity flows through the heating rod containing the nichrome coil, where it heats up quickly by using up 1,000 watts per hour, reaching temperatures of 40 to 90 degrees Celsius. The heat is evenly distributed to the surrounding water. Some heaters even come with thermostats to control the water temperature, automatically turning off when the desired level is reached. If the water has more calcium salt, then the immersion tube gets covered with a layer of calcium, which decreases the efficiency of the heater and increases the power bills. In order to remove the calcium layer, the tube needs to be cleaned with vinegar, which helps make the rod calcium-free